Hello, welcome back. Now in 2025. Today I wanted to briefly go over the visibility settings, particularly for objects. Especially in new Blender versions, it can be confusing as to which visibility setting to use, and also why you would use all of them, and not just have one singular visibility setting.
Well, you call this a happy family. Why do we have to have all these kids?
So let me go over them briefly. So I have this little test scene set up, and I have the outliner. In the visibility settings, these do not show up by default, the little monitors. But if you use this filter up here, you can toggle them off and on. There's also the selectable and holdout and indirect only. But those last two are specifically just for collections. I want to briefly go over what each of them mean and why you would use them. So for example, there's the hide in viewport. So that's the eye icon. That's the common one by default. You see like, okay, it hides it. Then why would they have a disable in viewport? And so the reason is that this hide in viewport is temporary, as it says in the description. So maybe you're working with a very dense scene and sometimes you're working on an object and another one kind of just gets in the way in the view. While I was working on my Christmas render, it was kind of a very close scene with a lot of characters next to each other and even some interior. And I needed some breathing room between the characters sometimes when I was working on each one. And so I would just quickly hide one of them and then reveal them back when I'm done. Now the difference between these two is their usage in memory. Now when you do a hide in viewport, you'll notice with your complex scenes especially, this is very quick, whereas with this can be a little slower. Now the reason is that the disable in viewport is taking the object out of the active memory in the viewport. So not only is it not being shown on screen, it's also not being calculated or referenced in the background. And with my naming, you'll see that there's the proxy object. So this is the original asset, and then this is the instanced one. So this one here. So you'll see that the proxy here is just the cube and it's shown in the viewport, but it's not shown in the render. It's disabled in the render. Now, why would we have all three of these settings? Again, the first one is just temporary. It's just when you want to temporarily hide something in the viewport to get it out of your way while you're working on something else. Not affecting memory or performance at all. It's still being referenced and used in other aspects of your scene. Whereas disable in viewport is specifically, I'm not using this new viewport. I don't want it to be seen in the viewport or affect performance, so get it out of here. This is especially important for high density, high quality objects that are slowing down your viewport performance, and you want to just take them out and only use it for the render. And so if I render this, you'll see that proxy mesh is gone, and as well as the Suzanne is gone. And that's because the render, the only one available in the render was this camera. Now, of course, I can bring the viewport Suzanne back into render, as she should be. But you'll notice when I hide the Suzanne on the original asset, it's still showing up here. Because again, this is a temporary hiding. This is not supposed to affect the usage of this instanced collection. And you'll notice that this disable in viewport and render visibility continues with all the instanced collections as well. Now you notice this checkbox, this is specifically for collections. If I hide it, of course the instance not affected, but it is. And this is specifically for view layers. Now, if you're not familiar with view layers, it's up here right next to scenes. It basically allows you to split up your render into different pieces. So you can just render the background or just render one specific character and nothing else. And splitting your big render into multiple view layers or separate renders, you can bring it up all together in compositing with the flexibility and not having to re-render everything in case there's something that didn't render as expected. Now, the other two is holdout. Holdout is specifically when you want to mask what's in that collection for the world background. So if I render again, you'll see that it masked out the original shape. This is more useful for more advanced compositing as well as visual effects, such as maybe you have a CG character standing at a desk, but you want the character to be behind the desk. And so you'll model out the desk in CG, and then you'd add this mask, this holdout, so that way the desk doesn't show up in the render, but the character is properly occluded behind the desk, if that makes sense. And this last one is indirect only. Now, indirect only is specifically when you don't want it directly visible in the scene, but you want it to still affect other objects in the scene, such as for lighting or caustics or things like that. And so these two attributes of mask and indirect only, the objects are still being part of the render, but this just changes how they're used in the render. So in terms of performance, the important ones to keep in mind is the view layer visibility, which again is for the entire view layer, disable and viewport, which will unload the object from memory while in the viewport, and then disable and render, which will take the object out of the render. And then of course the eye, which will hide the object from being drawn in the viewport, but it's still in memory. This is just a quick explanation of the visibility attributes. I hope you find this helpful. I'm wanting this to be part of kind of an optimization and scene management series as part of this channel. So let me know if you like this video and you want to see more optimization and scene management videos like this. I want to do more deep dives as well, but I feel this one was a simple enough one. Working on a few other projects right now, trying to get them all wrapped up. But I still wanted to get this one out because it's short and simple, but still useful. Thank you for watching, and happy blending.